हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंत फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 69।
5G ट्रायल्स इज सेट टू बिगिन इन इंडिया एंड यू कुड बी यूजिंग 5G ऑन योर फोन वेरी सून। रिलायंस जियो हैज ऑलरेडी कंफर्म दैट दे विल बी डेवलपिंग ए होम ग्राउंड एंड इंडिजिनियस 5G नेटवर्क, व्हाइल भारती एयरटेल हैज कंफर्मड ए सक्सेसफुल 5G टेस्ट ओवर ए कमर्शियल नेटवर्क। द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ टेली कम्युनिकेशन, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज सेड दैट द अप्रूवल्स ऑफ 5G ट्रायल्स हैव बीन गिवन एंड दैट टेलीकॉम कंपनीज विल बी अलॉटेड 5G स्पेक्ट्रम फॉर द ट्रायल्स सम टाइम दिस वीक। दिस मीन्स दैट टेलीकॉम कंपनीज including Reliance Jio, Bharti Airtel and VI could be in line to get the 5G spectrum for network trials across India. Samsung has been one of the leading suppliers of display panels to Apple for the iPhones, and the same arrangements is expected to continue for the upcoming models as well, even after the company increases order for LG Display and BOE. As per the new report coming from Korea, Samsung Display is now expected to ship 120Hz OLED display panel for the iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max model. This means that upcoming smartphones from Apple will have a smoother content as well as scrolling. A fake app that claims to help with COVID-19 vaccine registration has been doing the rounds. The app is a malware and it propagates itself via an SMS link sent to all the contacts of an affected device. Only the official COVID website and Arogya Setu app can be used for vaccine registrations in India. The ASUS ZenFone 8 series is all set to go official on May 12th. Reports have revealed that the lineup includes three handsets such as ZenFone 8 Mini, ZenFone 8 and ZenFone 8 Pro. The ZenFone 8 series will not be launching in India on May 12th, hence the Taiwanese manufacturer is likely to hold a dedicated launch event to announce the ZenFone 8 family. The India launch may be the next generation ZenFone flagship may not be far away, as the models have appeared in the database of the Bureau of Indian Standards. The Redmi has confirmed the launch of its first smartwatch, the Redmi Watch, in India on May 13th along with the Redmi Note 10S smartphone. It was launched last year in China and also available in some markets as Mi Watch Lite. The teaser image shows a watch with a silicone strap and has a button on the right side along with a launch date. The company also has confirmed that the watch has a built-in GPS, 11 sport mode, sleeping monitoring, heart rate monitoring, guided breathing, and will support 200 plus watch faces. The watch will come with a 1.4-inch touch-color LCD screen, 24-hour heart rate monitoring, 50-meter water-resistant for swimming, other notification for calls, SMS, and third-party application messages. The Redmi watch will support straps in several colors, and the price might be under ₹5,000 to compute with the latest Amazfit Bip U Pro. We should also know more details and the exact price of the smartwatch when it goes officially launches next week. Redmi K40 gaming phone is powered by the MediaTek Dimensity 1200 chipset. The Google Play console listing suggests a global launch of the phone is imminent. This phone is rumored to launch in India as a Poco F3 GT. Xiaomi launched the Mi 11 Ultra in India last month, however the smartphone is yet to be go on sale in the country. But as usual, the company had already sent out a review unit to media houses. Some of them have published their reviews as well. One such publication has revealed details of the accessories associated with this handset. The Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra supports a 67W wired charging and a 67W wireless charging. But the device ships with a 55W charger in India. Also, the fastest wireless charger sold by the company in India is capped at 30 watts. Tencent Games and Krafton have announced they are organizing the first PUBG Mobile National Championship in the United Kingdom, and China-based tech giant Xiaomi will be the title sponsor for the competition. It will be held from 4 June to 8 August, in which around 16 UK-based teams will be competing for the total prize money of €22,000, which is approximately $30,000, that is about 21 lakhs. The actual tournament series is slated to start from July 22nd till August 8th. The teams are invited to register and compete online in the PUBG Mobile National Championship Open Qualifier, which is taking place from June 4th till 11th June. To participate the PUBG Mobile National Championship United Kingdom Open Qualifier, teams must consist of a minimum number of 4 players with a maximum of 6 players from the same country. The winner of this tournament will also qualify for the 2021 PUBG Mobile Pro League Western Europe, which is set to take place this fall. The 2021 PUBG Mobile Premier League circuit will feature a $14 million total prize pool and 7 new regions including North America, Brazil, LATAM, CIS, Turkey, Arabia and Western Europe. PUBG Mobile have planned to host a variety of tournaments throughout the year in Western Europe, with a cumulative prize pool totaling about $400,000.
Microblogging site Twitter permanently suspended Bollywood actress Kangana Ranaut's account earlier on Tuesday. Ranaut's Twitter account has been permanently suspended after she posted a series of controversial tweets that go against the regulation guidelines of microblogging site. In the series of controversial tweets, Ranaut made comments on the alleged violence that took place in West Bengal after state election results were declared on Sunday, May 2nd. In the tweets that spurred this action, the actor was seen urging Prime Minister Narendra Modi to tame Bengal CM Mamata Banerjee using his viral trope from early 2000s. In addition, in one of the tweets, the actor demanded president rule in West Bengal after All India Trimonal Congress won the fight against BJP by majority seats over 200. Elon Musk is known for the witty responses on social media platform, from indulging in self-depreciating humors to replying with an eggplant emojis to a tweet. The Tesla and SpaceX CEO has made us all laugh time and again. Earlier, not many even believed in his worldview or business acumen until he sent his Tesla Roadster into space in his powerful Falcon Heavy rocket on its debut flight in February 2018. So when Musk says something, everyone pays attention, be it about cryptocurrency or colonizing the moon on Monday. He told a Twitter user it's not easy to do what he has achieved with Tesla. The Twitter user Utsav Techie appeared to suggest that many tech companies were either manufacturing or were in the process of manufacturing electric cars, from Apple to Xiaomi, LG to Sony, and Huawei to, of course, Tesla. To which Musk replied, "Prototypes are easy, but production is hard." In an earlier tweet, Musk had explained a little more on why he believed in the journey from prototype to production was so hard. He had tweeted, "Tesla and Ford are the only American car makers not to have gone bankrupt out of thousands of car startups." To which Ford CEO Jim Farley has responded, "Respect. Tesla is known as a pioneer in the electric vehicle space. Its popular electric passenger cars, including a Model 3 and a Model S and a Model Y. The company is set to enter the Indian market soon." The global true wireless earbuds market is expected to see a growth of 33% year-on-year in 2021, reaching a sizable 310 million units. This follows after a massive 78% year-on-year growth that the market saw back in 2020. The true wireless earbuds market saw shipments that slightly crossed expectation back in 2020, reaching 233 million units, although the performance was mainly driven by low to mid-range segments. Back in 2020, the coronavirus pandemic have impacted the true wireless earbuds market in China last year, but the situation has improved with the production capacities running at full capacity as well. Furthermore, the market demand for the product online has been higher than other electronic devices. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.